What's up? Last day of E3. I'm looking quiet right now. I mean, I'm here early. Gonna check out Hitman first. And I got Rage 2 later. It's gonna be packed today. I'm gonna look for a bathroom ASAP though, cause I gotta poop. Just got out of Days Gone. Here's a picture. Solid game, open world, kill a bunch of zombies. The mission I did was pretty much what they've shown off before a bunch. The first one was like get gas and fill up a car, then we drove out of there. It was more like a stealthy mission, but not a light stealth, it was early in the game. And then the second one was pretty much a whole pit of zombies, like Walking Dead style, and then kill the whole horde. Died a bunch, but like, so you're supposed to do like creative ways, I guess. Set up proximity mines. I was just trying to shoot them, didn't work. Set up proximity mines and stuff. And the game was slugging when all the zombies were running. It was chugging. Sometimes it was, sometimes it wasn't. So maybe it was just a bug thing that's gonna get hammered out. But I mean, of course it wasn't a final build. The game's coming out at 2/20/2019. But I mean, what was there is cool. Coming from Sony Bend, a handheld studio, now working on a console game. The cutscenes look great, but whether the story or maybe the gameplay hooks are all there, like, it feels good, but it's really an issue of, is there gonna be stuff to do? You know, like, you could argue, I wouldn't say so, but if you say Far Cry 5 feels good, there's of course the issue with the whole progression thing and the story that people aren't really into, and that's a big negative about the game. So could this have the same situation? Maybe, but from the two missions I played, they were interesting enough that I'd say, like, hey, this is a game to look out for. But, you know, it's not on Spider-Man or Last of Us scale. Days Gone isn't, I'm saying. But it's good. It plays well. I hope they hammer out the kinks before release. But that is my Days Gone impression. Also, talking about just how I even got there. So PlayStation has, like, this, like, special media booth, I guess. I don't even realize. People are calling it the PlayStation Arcade, where they scan my media badge. And they're like, yeah, walk in. And I sell, like, rooms for like Last of Us 2 interviews, Ghost of Tsushima, that's all behind closed door shit, which I assume is just what they showed off already. They also had Dreams playable there, Spider-Man, Concrete Genie, and just a couple other games. Not really that many games, like a couple VR games besides that. Just finished a Hitman 2 demo, got to play this race car F1 map, like a Monaco type thing, I'm not sure where it was. Had to kill one of the race car drivers, and she was only in the race car for the demo, but in the real game, she gets sometimes, if she wins the race or something, she gets out of the car, and you could blow her up and shit like that. I went with getting a disguise and a flamingo costume, and then sniping her. Took a bunch of snipes. I was kind of being directed by the demo lady, like, what to do, and she was, like, telling me where the sniper was and shit. I normally suck at these games. I'm not gonna pick this game up by any means, but the amount of ways you could kill the... They showed at the end all the other ways you could kill the target, and they looked very cool, and, you know, way more, it looks even more creative than Hitman 1, which is something, because that was a creative game. So it is more Hitman 1. The mirrors, she specified how the mirror tech now works. So mirror, it's real-time mirror, you know, it's not fake glossy mirrors like in other video games. You can actually get spotted in mirrors if you got like an angle, like security guards. Cool stuff. If you like Hitman, you'll like this game. What up? Just stole a bunch of Activision wireless, camped out at their fucking meeting room and just used all their Wi-Fi to upload the New York Video Game Critics Circle podcast with me and Harold. I needed some Wi-Fi to upload that. While I was waiting outside their meeting room, I saw Destin Legary and Deej from Destiny having a long Destiny conversation, wondering what they're talking about. Then I went over and had a good combo with CJ Gibson and Destin Legary while Deej was right there, but it seemed like he was talking to someone else. Either way, cool guys all around. I gotta figure out where the entrance is to the Kingdom Hearts 3 booth. Wow, just got to play the Kingdom Hearts 3 demo. Let me tell you something, what? I am excited for that game. I actually might pick it up. So the demo is two worlds. I'm sure you saw it everywhere online. It's the Toy Box, which is the Toy Story one, and then Olympus, which is from Hercules. The Toy Box one is more exploring and doing more stuff. The Olympus one is definitely more on rails. I enjoyed both of them very much. The cutscenes, I was kind of like picking up my phone. I wasn't really paying. I mean, when there was the characters I know, like Woody and Buzz talking, I was into it. But then when it was fucking some other Kingdom Hearts guy showed up, and you know, I'm like, I don't know what you're saying, so I'm not gonna like waste my time like trying to figure it out. Let me answer some texts. So my Kingdom Hearts experience, as you know, if you're a PS Best Friends podcast listener, I rented the collection and I got a couple hours into one, and I just wasn't feeling it. It felt like an old game. Everything around it seemed interesting. The ideas, the world seemed very cool, but just how the controls felt very archaic, very old to me. You would think that's the case with Kingdom Hearts 3, it being, you know, a Last Guardian type game, being in development hell forever. You know, Last Guardian came out, felt like a PS2 game, felt like it came out when it was originally supposed to. This is not the case with Kingdom Hearts. Kingdom Hearts feels like a game coming out in 2018, feels really good, feels better than most games. Camera got wonky in some areas, but you know, game's still coming out in January, and there is a lock on, so you could always just do that just in case. The moves felt smooth. It felt like a, I want to say like a more simplified Final Fantasy 15, but that's not really true. It feels like a better feeling Kingdom Hearts, you know, so you got all your abilities, all that stuff. Graphics look amazing. Environment looks amazing. I got in this like magical train from like Disneyland or something while in the Hercules Olympus level and pretty much destroyed this big Titan or whatever. I don't really know what the fuck was going on, but gameplay was tight. I don't think I could ever get on the level of the story, you know. I don't think any research or even playing one or two would help me out. So I'm just gonna jump in this one clean, not knowing much Kingdom Hearts 3 I'm talking about. And, you know, see what I get. Kingdom Hearts 3 made me a believer in this series, and I am extremely hyped for this game. Just spotted Hideo Kojima on the floor. Not really spot, more like he made himself known. He's walking, he's the only guy I've seen with a security team around him. And he's just walking around the show floor. Here's some footage, and he's just enjoying it as if, like, he doesn't have a team. That's very funny. I got some guy asking me who that was. Hey, you're not a Kojima, bro. Why you got E3? But that was funny. Now I'm heading to Bethesda. Oh, fuck, is that in this booth? Just got out of Rage 2. Had to pee the whole time. Rage 2 and Blades, the iOS Elder Scrolls game. Rage 2 is cool. I mean, it seems like the PC I was running it on, or maybe the build, it was mad screen tearing, very annoying. I mean, it looks fun. It looks like a Bulletstorm-esque. There's a new added abilities, which are fun. At points, like, I walked up to, like, looking out a window, like, to a nice mountain view, and all the mountains are, like, pink. I mean, it seemed like it was just like the way the coloring was, like, and with like clouds and stuff and mist, but like they're really just trying to recolor and not make everything brown, even though there was a good amount of brown. But color aside, it played fun, played well, classic id shooter, enjoyable game. It's not multiplayer, it's single player only, stress that. Just saw Pete Hines walking to the bathroom. Blades is the iOS game. I'm actually way more hyped on that one than Rage 2. Very simple controls. You tap to where you want to go when you're in straight up vertical mode, you know, your basic holding your iPhone mode. You tap where you want to go and it's like this, you hold and then you let go when the ring is complete to do a melee, and then you have other abilities you could do as well. When you're doing sideways, it's dual stick. Blades looks amazing. I don't know how this thing's running on a iPhone. I was running it on iPhone 10. Looked so good, looked freaking crystal, amazing graphics. But yeah, that was Bethesda. I'm more into Blades than I am on Rage 2. Either way, both are pretty solid games. That's there.
This is what you can use all now.
So this is the scene outside of Cyberpunk 77, outside of a meeting room, which is usually just, you know, very empty. Just a couple people with appointments are inside. This is what other fucking rooms look like. It is packed. People are trying to make reservations. People are trying to get in. I asked. They're booked solid. There's only 2 more hours left in the show. But yeah, that seems like to be the real hit of the show. So that sucks. I was not able to play it. Wowza, Bowza. Here's a crazy story for you. Going to Control, the new Remedy game, the makers of, wow, I got that white. The makers of Alan Wake, Quantum Break, their new game. I walk in, I say, oh, I'm here for the 3 o'clock. Okay, we have a room open right now. I was like 5 minutes early. Come with me. Wait 1 second. Right behind me, Kojima walks in, his whole entourage behind him. For some reason, there's a boom mic dude just fucking holding a boom mic in front of him. I don't get that. Jordan Voight Roberts in the behind him totally walks like right by me, like shirts pretty much touched. He goes in through him. The guy's like, oh, you know, just hold on 1 more second. He's like, let me check on the room again. Kojima's back there. He comes back. He's like, yeah, just wait a second. Now I'm waiting like more, like moved into the room more. Kojima and crew walk all out, like the whole entourage, leave the place. Once again, passes right by me, shirts touching. And then he goes on his merry way. And then as Kojima's walking out, fucking, I see Igarashi as well in another room. So I got to see Control being played, a hands-off demo. This game looks amazing. This is a, they pitched it as a supernatural third-person action game. You have like teleportation abilities, levitation abilities. You have this cool gun that's like, choose you. You're the president of the Federal Bureau of Control, and wacky shit's going on is pretty much the gist of it. I assume it's all going to be explained in the game, but you know, it's a mysterious game. It's one of those. So it's open, it's more open than other Remedy games. You know, it's not as linear. There are different sections of this building you could go into, and each like where place you go into is like different each time or something. Not procedurally generated, but like what you would imagine that would be. So like you walk into a room and it's like all like new or something, you know. But of course that's a pre-made level. It's not none of the game is randomization. It's all pre-made, but I'm saying like that idea where like you walk into a room and it's different or something, you know, like messing with your head. You could pick up like debris and use it to as a block, like levitate style, which is really cool. Once again, yeah, this Metroidvania thing. So like when you unlock the levitation ability, then you could start using that. The hovering ability you could do also. It's a really cool game. The shooting looked very tight. The world looks very interesting. There are side quests you could do. Overall, it looks like a great game. I also got to check out Bloodstained finally, Ritual of the Night, the new Igarashi game, maker of Symphony of the Night, Castlevania. Cool game, plays very well. Art style is cool. The 2.5D works. I mean, the 16-bit, of course, would be cooler, but that's way harder to make. But yeah, no, game looks cool. Looks classic Castlevania. Feels tight. Feels like it's going to be fun to play the full thing. I like how the weapons work. You know, magic is how it was in Symphony of the Night, where, like, you use magic, but, like, slowly regenerating, and that's how you use all your spells, so you could use them way more frequently than games that just have very stagnant mana bars. Just got out of Metro Exodus demo. Lengthy. 50 minute long they let us play. Maybe it's just a 45 minute session until how long you, however far you get. It's cool. It's mostly outside of the tunnels, actually. So if you're claustrophobic or whatever, this game is the one for you. It's open world. It's mostly outside. Kind of, you know, a Fallout feel, actually. Towards the end of the demo, some NPC was like, oh, look, go to that section, you could go to that part, because we're at a high point and we had binoculars. He's like, oh, you could go to that refinery, that oil rig or whatever. And so I guess like it's very open world. It still has that overall jank. I mean, this is a demo, but still, I played Metro Redux. It still has that overall jank that the Metro series has, but it's still fun. You know, it still is that survival first person shooter, not survival horror really, just like survival first person shooter. Yeah, I mean, the environment is cool. The weapons are still very cool. The game concepts are all there that worked in the other games, but it's less linear this time. So I guess that's a plus. But yeah, we got 1 hour left of E3. I'm heading over to PlayStation's booth to try to get some quick Dreams game-ing done. Gonna want to say Greg. I have no idea if you could see that. It looked terrible. E3 is over, but it would not be a good E3 if I did not play Tetris. Tetris Effect, I just got finished playing at PlayStation's booth. It is the VR Tetris game. It's pretty solid. It's like a VR Luminous thing, but the gameplay is Tetris. It was actually a little hard to go play fast and do good combos because there's so much shit was being thrown at your face. A lot of particle effects happening. Some like weird slow down, like part of the game, like part of the music stuff. Cool experience, very fun experience, but not the greatest Tetris game if you're just going solely for high scores. There you have it. That has been Jeffrey Miz's Mr. Brawl 86 French Toast PS Best Friends vlog series from E3. Look at everyone all walking in the same direction. We're all walking out of this fucking Coliseum, Convention Center, whatever you want to call it. Overall, E3 was amazing. Got to play Spider-Man one more time, actually, just before I left. That, I think that's my game of the show. I have to go over all the games I played. But Spider-Man is so fucking good. E3 as a whole was amazing, but don't go if you're a gamer. Only go if you're media. Gamers are just waiting online all day. I'm actually doubling back right now to go to the bathroom. Gamers waiting online all day, literally 6 hours to play a fucking 10-minute demo. Some of the demos I played, if I waited fucking as many hours as they waited, I'd cry. I would not want to do this. But there you have it. If you say there you have it 5 times, it becomes a video. Remember to listen to our podcast, PS Best Friends, on all podcast platforms. Subscribe to this YouTube channel here. Follow us on Twitter, @PSBFPodcast. And, you know, thanks for watching.